Good morning. Welcome to my YouTube channel, School of Advanced Economics. I am inspired by my students and parents to begin this channel. I thought teaching and learning process would become effective only if we make such videos on our subject. I will try my level best to make the concept so easier. If you love my videos, please like it and share it. Please subscribe my channel by clicking the bell button and enable it to all so that you will get notifications whenever I upload new videos. I request not to forget to leave your comments so that I may rectify myself and can come out with better words. So let us begin the lesson. Dear children, you have studied about economics in your previous classes, like class 9 and 10. But in those classes, you have studied only a little about economics. But in class 11 and 12, you are going to study the elaboration of those topics you have already studied. So you know a little about economics. Economics, what is the meaning of economics? From where the word economics has derived from? You know, economics is derived from the Greek word oikonomia. 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 From this Greek word, economics, the word economics is derived from. So, what is the meaning of the word oikonomia? The word oikonomia means household management. Due to lack of space, I may not able to write everything. Household management. You know, so let us define the economics. Economics is a social science which deals with human wants and satisfaction. You might have heard of Adam Smith. You know, Adam Smith, he is known as father of economics. He is a Scottish economist. He is from Scotland. He has written a famous book, An Inquiry into the Nature and Wealth of Nations. This is the full name of the book written by Adam Smith. But due to lack of space, I write only Wealth of Nations. See, so he has written a famous book, An Inquiry into the Nature and the Wealth of Nations. This book was published in 1776. So we studied economics. Economics is a social science that deals with the human wants and satisfaction. Many economists like Lionel Robin, he also give a definition to economics. According to him, economics is a science which studies human behavior as a relationship between ends and scales. Ends and scales. Ends. Ends and scales. Ends and scales. What is the meaning of ends? Ends means unlimited ones. Unlimited ones. Scales means limited resources. Limited resources. So, Leonel Robbins, he has given a clear definition to economics. It is a science which deals with human behavior as a relationship between ends and scales. This was the which alternate uses. So, this is a clear-cut definition given by our famous economist, British economist, Leonard Robin. You know, so what is the meaning of, we studied about economics. What is the meaning of an economy? What is mean by an economy? An economy is a system. You know, when you look around, you can see many things. Like flyovers, you can see many shops, you can see railways, railways are working, next many mining activities are going on. These are a kind of economic activities. These are things will give life to the people, you know. So we can say that an economy is a system. An economy is a system that gives life to the people. You know, an economy is a system that gives life to the people. Moreover, so in order to give life to the people, every economy has to undertake three things. So, what are those these three things? Let us see what are those three things. So, in order to give life to the people, every economy has to undertake three things of activities every economy has to undertake. So what are those three things? First one is consumption. Second one is production. Third one is investment. So, in order to give life to the people, every economy has to undertake three things. What are they? Consumption, production and investment. So, let us discuss what is meant by consumption. So, what is the meaning of consumption? I use this pen. Why I use this pen? Because it gives some kind of utility to me, some satisfaction. So that is the reason why I use this pen. So consumption means use of economic goods and personal services in the satisfaction of human wants. This is called the consumption. I am a teacher. I am an economics teacher. Children come to me and learn from me if they are satisfied only. So a good should give a satisfaction to the consumer. Then only the people will consume the goods. Consumption play a very important role in every economy. If people are not, for example, you see the pandemic situation, corona, due to this corona situation, many people are not coming out. They are not coming out for purchasing things. So consumption is very reduced. Consumption is reduced. As a result of the reduction of consumption, production will not happen. You know, many companies were closed. Many shops were closed. All markets were closed during this pandemic situation. What was the reason? People are not going to the market. People are not going and purchasing the things. consumption is reduced. Why people reduce the consumption? Due to lack of income. People do not have income. If they do not have income, how will they go and purchase things? So consumption means consumption decides everything. Because of consumption, a chain of incidents takes place. You know, see, so if consumption is not happen, production will not happen. If production will not happen, what will happen? Employment will not be created. If employment is not created, income will not be generated. If income is not generated, standard of living will go down. Standard of living of the people will go down. These are the chain of incidents related to consumption. So consumption means use of economic goods and personal services in the satisfaction of human wants. Consumption plays a very important role in economy. If consumption is not happen, this production will not happen. If production will not happen, employment will not generated. If employment is not generated, income will not be generated. If income is not generated, standard of living will not be there. People cannot lead a standard of life. These are the things we are studying about consumption. So consumption means use of economic goods and personal services in the satisfaction of human wants. So in order to give a life to the people, every economy there should have a consumption. So I think you might have understood consumption. Next let us learn about production. So what is the meaning of production? Production means a transformation of raw materials. This is in economics. Literally mean production means to create something. In production means create something. In economics, production means a conversion of raw materials into finished goods. What is the meaning of finished goods? Means that while finished goods means the goods on which value addition cannot be made. Though this is called production. Production means finished goods. This is called finished goods. So production means conversion of raw materials into finished goods. So next one is investment. Investment, what is the meaning of investment? Investment means in addition to the existing stock of capital. So capital we have to add more capital to the existing capital. This is called investment. So here we have studied about consumption, production and investment. So once again I will tell about the topic consumption. Consumption means use of economic goods and personal services in the satisfaction of human wants. So every economy in order to give life to the people, every economy has to undertake three kinds of economic activities. Every economy has to undertake. First one is consumption. Second one is production. Third one is investment. So what is the meaning of consumption? Consumption means use of economic goods and personal services in the satisfaction of human wants. So you know, consumption is, consumption play a very important role in every economy. Consumption creates production. If consumption is not happen, production will not happen. You know, because production depends on consumption. If people do not go to market, company will not produce things. If the people are not going to market and if they are not purchasing things, company will not produce anything. Company will close down. So if the company closes down, what will happen? If the company closes down, employment will not be generated. generated. If employment will not be if employment is not generated, income will not be generated. If income is not generated, standard of living of the people will go down. So these are the chain of incident happens with the consumption. The next one is a production. You already studied production. What is the meaning of production? Production means conversion of raw materials into finished goods. Means finished goods means those goods on which value addition cannot be made. We cannot change any, we cannot make any changes to that good. Means it is finally used. That is the finished goods. So investment. What is the meaning of investment? Investment means in addition to the existing stock of capital. So these are the things we studied here. Again, we will learn the. I will come out with the next topic in the next video. Thank you.